concept is where class. What is the use of where class? Conditionally, or we can say retrieve the data, or we can simply say filtering the data. Filtering records based on condition. Retrieve the data based on the condition. We can use where condition along with the select statement. Now I will show you a few examples how to use where condition. So currently I'm pointing to the HR database and employees table is already there. So now I'm going to execute all these commands on HR database, employees table. I will show you one by one. So what is exactly use of this command, in how many ways we can apply where condition one by one. So here I'm closing this. I'm again opening new query editor. So I'm copying this command, and before that I will just ship to the database. Let's say use, whenever you open the new query editor, just execute this use command first time, okay? And use HR, execute this. So that's it. So now our session is currently focused on HR database. Fine. So now we will see how these queries are working. So the first command is select star, the simple command. So when I say select star, what happens? This will give you all the data from employee. So now I'm selecting this command and execute only that command. So now we can see here, and what is the data it is retrieved. So this is the data which is written by the command base. Okay, first command. So it is retrieved all the rows and as well as all the rows. All the rows means we have filtered here, limit to 10 rows we set, right? Don't put here, don't put limit, and then it will give you all the data. So when I execute this, now this much data we have in this employee table. Almost 206 records are available. So select star from employee means 206 records are available in the table. So now my requirement is I want to print the data, or I want to print the employees details whose salary is greater than 33,000, or we can say 30,000. So I think very less number of salaries are there. So I can just use 3,000. So I want to print the employees data here whose salary is greater than 3,000. So that's my requirement. So how we can write the query now? Select star from employees, select star from employees where, so here we need to put the condition, because select star from employees will give you all the data. So once you get the data, now on top of it, we need to apply the condition. So where salary column greater than 3000. So now what happens? First it will retrieve the data, then apply the filter, and rest of the records will be printed in my output. Okay, so let me execute this. So currently total number of records are 206, right? So once we executed this command, now we'll see how many records are displayed. So total again 206 is displayed. I think all the salaries are greater than 3000. So let me put in different number. I'll say instead of 3000, I'll say 20,000. Okay, now execute this query. So this time there is only one record is there. Only one employee is having more than 20,000 salary. So let me put 15,000, then we'll get few records. So 15,000, then execute this. Now we will get three records. So three employees are having salary whose salary is greater than 15,000. Okay, so now you can verify here. So this is a one query, guys. We can filter the data based on a condition, and that particular condition we can specify by using where class. And similarly, I want to print the data of the employees whose salary is less than 15,000. I say less than or equal to or less than, that's fine. So equal to means it will also consider 15,000. Okay, so now I have written opposite condition. So I want to print employees data whose salary is less than or is equal to 15,000. Now execute this command. Select this command and then execute. So now we have got a lot of records. Just moving above, so almost we have got 206 records. So sorry, this is not exact record number, guys. Employee IDs, these are all employee IDs. Okay, so these are all just employee IDs. So we got some data. So if you see this particular column, salary column, all the employee salary is less than 15,000. So let's put a smaller number, let's say less than 10,000. Then execute. So we got few data here, few data sets. So these employee salaries are less than 10,000. All of them are all since less than 10,000. Or let's say put 5,000 only. So this time again, the data will be reduced. So again, execute. So this time also we got the data. So now these salaries are less than or is equal to 5,000, all the salaries. Okay. So this is how we can apply the condition. So now there is another requirement. Suppose I want to display the employees data who are belongs to department number 30. So I have a lot of data here, and the last column we have employee department ID, right? So some of the employees are belongs to 50, some of them are 30, 60. So there are n number of departments are there. So let me execute star command once again. So because we can see all the department IDs, 90, 60, 100, 50, 80. So these are all department IDs. Now I want to print the employees who are belongs to department number 30. So 30 is there or not? Yes, 30 is available. So I want to print the employees data who are belongs to department ID 30. So then what I can do is select a star from employees where department ID is a column which is equal to 30. Now it will get all the data, then apply this particular filter. Now execute this, you will get the data who are belongs to only 30. Department ID is only 30. Okay, so this is the one thing. And the other query is, suppose I want to also can validate the nulls. So this is very, very, very important thing, guys. Nulls, operations on nulls is very, very important concept in database. So we can apply these operators. So less than or equal to, these operators we can use on any other columns, perfectly right. But we cannot use these operators on null columns. Suppose if there is any value, any column value is a null, we cannot apply arithmetic operations on null. We cannot apply arithmetic operators on null columns. So we have a special operator called is. So is operator we have to use. Suppose here, when I run my select star from employees, so now I'm just removing this. So I have this particular data. So I got all the data here. Now, if you see the commission underscore PCT, in this particular column, every time always almost all the zeros, and there is only one column is there. So there will be some null is there in one place. There should be some null. Only one record is having null. So that is commission underscore PCD. So one record is having null. So I think this is the only one. So now I want to retrieve the data whose column is having null. I want to filter the data based on the null. So here I'm saying employees where commission underscore PCT is null. In the commission underscore PCT having some values also, but wherever the nulls are occurred, I'm getting only that particular data. So when you want to compare with the nulls, don't use equal to, less than or equal to. We should not use equal to here. This is not correct because we cannot apply arithmetic operators on nulls. So that is another important fundamental point. We cannot apply the arithmetic operators on nulls. So this will give you wrong actually. So when I execute this, so nothing is given. So let me just put is. Suppose we should have some data, otherwise it will not give you properly. So I have executed. So it is also not giving anything. So I think it should be the case letter. Let me check it. So it will be treated as same actually. So nothing. Okay, so there is only one record with the null guys, so it is giving that particular record. So we will see, is there any other table with the null values, then we can apply that. So let me just go to MyDB. We have a student data, right? So let's go to student data. And I'm just closing this guys, or we can open one more editor, no issues. We can open multiple tabs also, right? We can open multiple query editors. So in the second editor, I'm working with another table. So in the first query editor, you can work with one database. In another query editor, you can also work with another database. So now in the second query editor, I switch to the MyDB. So I'll say use MyDB. Okay. Now execute this command. Now we are pointing to MyDB here in this particular section. Now here I have a student table. So let me just select the data. Select a star from student and execute this command. So it will give you three records, and the last record is last one is called as a null, right? Now I want to retrieve the record. I want to retrieve the student details whose marks is null. Okay. Now let's execute this command. Select star from, select a star from student, select a star from student where marks, M-A-R-K-S, marks is equal to, I'll say null here. Mars is equal to null. So suppose instead of null, I will say first some number. Okay, Mars is equal to 80, I'll say. So now when I execute this query, it is giving one record perfectly right. Now this time I will say null here. Now execute this. I think null we should give in different way. Sorry, I'll say null. Okay, and then semicolon. So execute this query. So once we have executed, we don't get the data because we have a data with a null value. The last record is also having null, right? Last record Mars value is null, but we don't get the data here. Why? Because this equal to operator will not work on nulls. Not only equal to, plus, addition, subtractions, these things will not work on null because null is not a number, not a string. It is a just unknown value. Okay, so but what we need to do here is we need to use an operator called is operator. Just use is operator. Now this should work. So execute. So now we got the data. So this is how we need to use is operator, and this is also conditional based retrieval of data. Okay, so this example I have given here, and the next query again we'll go back to the first editor, employee DB. So the next one is select a star from employees where first name is equal to this one. So I want to retrieve the data based on the first name. Suppose I have all the records here. So in all the records, I want to display the records whose first name is Jennifer. So now I apply the condition on the first name. So execute this command. It will give you only two records because these two records exactly having Jennifer is a first name. So is it exactly matching? So like this, we can filter, guys. So suppose, so let's see this command. So here I have used distinct operator. This is another operator. So where we need to use a distinct is very simple. Suppose, see this command. This is also very, very important, distinct keyword. So apart from the where, we can also use distinct keyword. I'll show you what is the use of distinct keyword. It is very, very important question in interviews. And suppose here, when I write this query without having distinct, now what happens? I'm just removing this one. Select a department ID from employees. When I run this query, it will give you all the department IDs in the output. And you can see here, there are a lot of duplicates are there, right? Hundreds are repeated and 90s are repeated, 80s are repeated. So there are duplicates also there in the output. Now, I don't want to have the duplicates. I want to get the unique records. So if I have a 10 is repeated 10 times, I don't want to print 10 times. Just I want to print only one time. And 20 is repeated 5 times, I don't want to print 5 times. I want to print only one time. So that means I need to print the data uniquely. So then I can use a distinct operator. So instead of you preparing the when you're printing the department ID here, just add one keyword called distinct before that column name. And then it will give you only unique records. It will not be displayed any duplicates. So now execute this. This will give you unique records. Now you can see nothing is duplicated here. 10, 0, 20, 30, 40, all the department IDs are displayed here. So distinct is used to display the unique records. This is also very important. Displays unique records from a table. So it will avoid the duplications. So that's a distinct operator, guys. So without distincts, with the distincts, that is a difference. Okay, and we can also use distinct keyword along with the star because there are some records will be there. So there are some records will be duplicated sometimes, right? So if I don't want to display the duplicate, so I want to get only unique rows of data, then I can also use a distinct operator along with the star. And then it will check all the columns in distinct way. Like it will give you only distinct. Suppose if you see employee ID, it will be unique. First name also unique. Last name is also unique. Email also unique. So it will give you data like that. Okay. So we can apply the distinct keyword to filter or to avoid the duplicates, to filter the unique data from the table. So that is all about distinct keyword. Okay, so these are all different ways we can apply the filters on the table data along with the select command. So where command is very, very useful, guys. So where is basically used for filtering the data from the table, And we can use all kinds of operators, less than, greater than, all these things. Especially when you are working with the nulls, we use is command or is not. So both will be there. Okay, so this is all about where class. Where class is used to retrieving the data from the table based on certain condition. But select class is used to retrieve the data. But on top of that, if you want to apply any filter or condition, we use where class. Okay, so these are all different examples I have given. So next we'll move on to the operators. So whenever you're retrieving the data, we use certain number of operators. So in the last examples also, I use less than, greater than, less than or is equal to, greater than or equal to, right? Similarly, we have certain number of operators are there in SQL. So what are those operators? And or not. So these are called logical operators. So in the previous examples, whatever I have used, these are all arithmetic operators. Greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, these are all arithmetic operators. Now here, these are all the logical operators. And when we need to go for logical operators, if we want to check more than one condition, then we can go for logical operator. If you want to check more than one condition, then we can go for logical operator, and or not. Now I will show you how to use and or not operators. Okay. So now let us see how we can use it. So first of all, let's go to the editor again. I'm just closing the second one. We don't require that. So here I am selecting the data from employees table. Let's say select star from employees. Select star from employees. Execute this command. So this will give you all the data in the table currently, right? So now what we need to do is we need to use this particular operator. So I'll increase the conditions now. Previously I used a where class to put one condition on the table, but this time I'm going to put multiple conditions. So see this one. If you see this particular query, select a star from employees where salary greater than 15,000 and job ID should be this one. So what is this logical operator works is how this will work is first it will check the first condition. So it will consider two columns, salary column and job ID column, because we put the condition on two columns, salary column and job ID column. So all the salary column, it will check employees salary is 15,000 or not, first of all. So if the salary is 15,000 and also the job ID of that employee should be AD_VP. So first it will check the salary is greater than or not. Also it will check the job ID should be AD_VP. If even one of them is not satisfied, that will not pick up that record. Okay, so if one of the condition is not satisfied, it will not pick up that particular record. So both should be satisfied. So that is the AND operator. But OR operator, the same thing I have written by using OR operator, means either this one or this one should be satisfied. At least one of the condition should be satisfied, and then it will retrieve the record. That is AND OR. Now NOT is also another operator. So select star from employees where not first name is equal to David means other than this first name David, rest of the records will be displayed. Only it will avoid first name is David record. That record, except that record, rest of the records will be displayed. Right? So this is AND OR NOT. So let's try these commands. Go to your workbench and here I will execute these commands. And we need to keep these brackets correctly, guys. Otherwise, it will run into issues. And putting the bracket single quotation. Sometimes when you copy from other files to your editor, some special characters will be added, some single quotes will be changed. So you have to make sure properly you have to use this keyword. See now, when I copy from the presentation, it is getting changed. So we have to put some proper things. All right, so now everything is perfect. So what I'm going to do now here is select a star from employees, select a star from employees where salary greater than 15,000 and job ID is equal to this one. So let's execute this query now. Now you can see it is displayed only two records. And if you see the salary and job ID, first let's say salary column, salary is 17,000. So the condition is matched. So I'm expecting salary should be 15,000. So it is saying 70,000. Perfectly right. And job ID should be also AD underscore VP. So if you see job ID here and here AD underscore VP. So this is also satisfied. End operator should satisfy both the things and then only it will retrieve the data. Instead of end operator, suppose when I execute the second one, OR operator, now we will get one more record. So three records. So in this record, and especially these two records we already get earlier, this record is specially we got. So why we got this record? Because the salary is greater than 24,000. So the first condition is matched. So even though second condition is not matched, still we got the data. Still we got the data. So OR condition means either first condition or second condition should be matched. And then that particular record will be retrieved by the select command. So that is OR operator. And then we have one more operator called NOT. Okay, so suppose if I don't say NOT here, it will give you only one record who is having David. So now I have a three records which contains the first name David. And three records are exactly matching. Now, if I say NOT operator here, other than these three records, rest of the records will be displayed. Now, when I execute this, you don't see the David here. In the first name, you don't see David entry anywhere else. Okay, so other than those three records, rest of the data will be displayed in the output. So that is all about NOT operator. So end or NOT. We can also filter the data and we can also add more number of conditions along with the where class to filter the data from the table. Okay, so that is all about end or NOT operators. These are called logical operators. So the next one is between and in operators. Between and in operator. Suppose I want to retrieve the data and that data should fall under certain range. So then how we can specify? Certain range should be there. So then we can use between operator. So we can use between operator. So let me show you these two commands. Between and not between. See this. So these are the two queries. So the first query is select a star from employees where salary between 10,000 and 12,000 I'm specifying. So salary between 10,000 and 12,000. So when I execute this query, it will give you salaries data. All salaries are fall under only 10,000 and 12,000. Okay. So the same query we can write in different way. If I don't want to use between and operators, we can also write the same query in different way. So let me write this. So here select star from employees where salary, I'm saying salary should fall under 10,000 and 12,000. Between 10,000 and 12,000, right? So what I'm saying here is salary greater than or is equal to 10,000. Okay. And again, same condition, salary. Okay. Salary less than or is equal to 12,000. The same query I can write in different way by using arithmetic operators. See this. Okay. So this will also give the same data. This will also give the same data. Now we can see salary should fall under between 10,000 and 12,000. Okay. So what is the difference between this one and this one? No difference. Only the, we have used different operator. So salary between 10,000 and 12,000. So if you want to specify certain range, we can use between operator, between operator. Okay. And suppose other than this range, I don't want to get the data between this range. Then I need to use not between. This is a negative operator. So not between is a negative operator. So other than this particular range, rest of the salaries will be printed. Now when I execute this, this will give you other salaries. So in this particular salary column, we don't find any salaries which are between 10,000 and 12,000. So now we can see different salaries we can see here, but they are not fall under between 10,000 and 12,000. So this is how we can use between operator. Between means we can specify a certain range and between that range we can get the record from the table. And select star from employees table name where salary between 10,000 and 12,000. So SQL is very, very simple language, guys. It's simple to just like English. Okay. So if you understand this, very, very clear. So select star from employees where I am saying salary between 10,000 and 12,000. So this will give you the salaries between 10,000 and 12,000. And the second command will give you salaries which are not fall under 10,000 and 12,000. So this is all about between operator, between and not between. So we have another operator called in, not in operator. In or not in operator. So let me write these queries. In and not in operator. See this, guys. The first query, see this. My requirement here is, so my requirement here is, I want to print the employee's data. I want to print the employee's data whose salary is exactly equal to 3400, 2500 and 3000. So I want to print the data of the employees whose salary is exactly equal to 3400, 2500 or 3000. I'm saying or means this one or this one. One of the salaries should be matched. And all those employees I want to retrieve. Now, when I execute this query, this will give you few records. So if you see here output salary column, so this salary column exactly having either 2500 or 3400 or 3000, right? So that means whatever the condition is matched, that particular required data is retrieved here. But here, if I have 10 values, so like this, I have 10 salaries. I want to compare. So then I put R, it will be very huge condition, right? So instead of that, we can just simplify that by using in operator. So the same query I can write by using in operator here. So we see here, select a star from employees where salary in, and here you can specify all the salaries by separating comma. Now it will always check salary is there or not in this list. If it is there, get the record, and again check the another salary is there, get the record, and there get the record. So it will check, the in operator will check whether the salary value is there in this list or not. If it is there, it will retrieve the record. If it is not there, it will leave the record, and this will also give the same output. So now we can also see 2500, 3400 and 3000. So these two are exactly the same query size. Suppose I want to retrieve the data whose salaries is not equal to these values, not equals to these values. Now I simply say not in negation. So now other than 3400, 2500, 3000, rest of the salaries data we will get. So now in this output, we don't see anywhere 3400 or 2500 and 3000. Okay. So this is how we can use in operator, not in operator. So these are also called special operators in MySQL. So in means it will check the salary is present inside this or not, then those records will be retrieved. Not in means this check the salary is not in this particular list or not, then those records will be retrieved. So that is the use of in and not in operators. Okay, so between in operators we have seen, between not between, in not in, so negation also is applicable. So the next one is pattern matching. These are all topics we are going to use with select command itself. As I said beginning, select command is very huge. We can do a lot of things by using select command. Okay. So now we will see pattern matching operators. What is pattern matching operators? Also called as wildcard characters. Pattern matching operator are also called wildcard characters. So let's see what are they. Suppose I want to retrieve the data from the employees. Let's say select a star from employees. So this command will give you all the data from the table. So I want to get the data only on first names. Okay. So what I can say here, I'll say first name, only first name I'll say, then I will get the only first name records. Sorry, first underscore name record. So when I execute this, it will give you only the first names. Sorry, let me execute one more time. So now I got the only first names. But again, what I want to do is, I want to filter this data also. I want to filter the first names whose names are starting with some character or S or E or D, whatever. Or I want to display the first name whose first two characters are S, U or D, A. Or last character is end with R or middle character is something. Okay, how we can specify all these things? So we can specify these things by using wildcard characters. Suppose I want to print the first names whose names are starting with S. So Sundar, Shelly, Sarath, I want to display only those first names. What I can write is, I can write query like this. So select this first name from employees where first name underscore, first underscore name, like operator we have to use. Like in the single quotations, we need to specify. So the first name should be, first character should be yes. So I'll say yes, and rest of the characters can be anything. So I'll just say star here, S star. So what are the wildcard characters? Sorry, not star, percentage. So it should be percentage. So what does it mean is, first name like this one. So what is this means? This is called as a regular expression, we can call it, or we can call it wildcard characters or pattern matching. So now what happens is, this particular condition will verify first name is starting with yes character or not. And rest of the characters can be anything, because percentage is representing the multiple characters. Percentage is representing the multiple characters. So after yes, whatever characters are coming, that those characters can be anything. But the first character should be yes. So when I execute this particular query, it will give you the first names who are starting with only yes. Now you can see all the names are starting with yes. So this is called as a pattern matching. So for this, we have a two operators here. One is percentage representing many characters and underscore representing single character. So percentage representing many characters, underscore representing single character. So while specifying the patterns, we need to use these two commands. Okay, so now I'll show you a few important things here. Let me copy these queries and we'll see how these things works. And carefully put the semicolons and everything, right? So now, so first command. So this command I already shown you. So select star from employees where first name like yes slash s percentile means percentiles representing many characters. So after yes, you can have any number of characters. So execute this, it will give you. So I say star so that it is giving all the columns. But if you say the first name here, all the first names are starting with the S character. Okay, so this is the first one. And the second one, what is this one? Select a star from employees where first name, again first name. First name like percentile R. What does it mean? So percentile representing many characters, but the last character should be R. So here R should be last character. Every name should end with the R character. And below, before R, it can have any number of characters. Now execute this command, it will give you all the names whose names are end with the R. If you see, every name is end with the R, last character. Okay, so this is how we need to use. S is a starting character here and followed by multiple characters. And here first starting with multiple characters, end with the R. Now see this one. So this is another one. So what is the meaning of it? So first name like, first character should be yes, and after that you can have any number of characters, percentile representing multiple characters. So after yes, you can have any number of characters, and it should end with the R. So what does that mean is, starting character should be S, the last character should be R. So that's the meaning of this, and only those first names will be displayed. Now execute it. Now we can see there is only one first name with that condition. So starting character is S, the end character is R, and between you can have any number of characters. So this is the way of writing the pattern matching. So S is a first character representing the first character. R is representing the last character. In between you can have any number of characters. Percentage representing number of characters, many characters. All right, so now we'll see the next query. So this one, so select a star from employees where first name like percentile M percentile. What does that mean? So percentile representing multiple characters. You can have any characters, and in the middle somewhere you can have M. After that, again, you can have multiple characters. So what does that mean is, any first name should have M character somewhere in the middle, right? Somewhere in the middle. And it should not be first character. It should not be last character. Somewhere in the middle, the character should be there, because percentile is representing many characters, and this percentile is representing again multiple characters. So in between, the M should be there. Now execute this query. So this will give you the all the first names. Just observe this. For every first name, there will be some character called M. So here it is there, here it is there. So everywhere. Let me execute one more time. So this one. Okay. So now we can see every name should have M. So after M, even if you don't have any characters, no issues. It will not give. If you have some characters after M, it will give you, or else it will leave. Nothing will happen. So that's the reason we got even William, these things also, Adam, Pam. So last character will be M. But after that, if there are any other characters also, it will be retrieved. But there are no characters, it will leave it. So this particular regular expression or pattern matching will give you the first names who are having M as a middle letter. And the next one is this one. So service start from employees whose first name not like. See this. So this is again different term. I have used a like operator here. One second. Not like. So first name, not like. Not like. Yes, percentile. What does it mean? So whenever we use pattern matching, we use like operator, guys. Okay, we should not use equal to. So pattern matching should always work with the like operator. Okay. So the next one is this one. Not like. What does it mean is, when I run this code, it will give you all the names whose name should not start with the yes character. That is the meaning of this. So here, actually, what is the regular expression saying? First character should be yes. Rest of the characters can be anything. But first character should be yes. But here I say not. Not like. So it will get the data a negative way. So like it will not start with S. It should not start with S. So now if you see the first names, so no names have started with the S. All are started with the different characters. Okay, so this is not like operator. So in these examples, I have shown you only percentile operator, which representing the multiple characters, all these things, right? But what about the single character? So now see this. So in this particular expression, I have written select star from employees where first name like and percentile E one underscore I have given one underscore. What does it mean is underscore representing single character. Okay. Underscore representing single character. Now what kind of data it will retrieve is first I say percentile means representing many characters. After character somewhere it should have E. After E, there should be only one character. So after E, it should be only one character is allowed. If you have more characters after E, it will not get the data. So before E, you can have any number of characters. But after E, you should have only one character. So only that kind of data will be returned. Now when I execute this, observe this output, first name. So the last character, E, after E, there should be only one character is eligible. Now if you see the Steven. So after E, there will be a character called N is there. N is there, right? So now the second one is Lex is there. So Lex means L is matched and E is also matched. After E, there is X character is there. And here also after E, R is there. Here after E, L is there. Last two characters I'm saying. Okay, last two characters I'm saying. In each and every first name, the last two characters, if you notice, the first character will be E followed by only one character. After E, you don't see many characters at the end of the name. So that's the meaning of this. Before E, you can have any number of characters. But the last digit E, after E, you should have only one character. So that particular first name will be written here. So that is all about single quotation, single underscore. And one more last one. Suppose I want to retrieve the first names and whose first names having only three digits or three characters. So whoever is having first name with three characters, only three characters, I want to retrieve the data. So I can just say three underscores here. So because underscore representing single character, when I say three underscores here, it will retrieve the first names who are having three characters. Now, when I run this code, it will give you first name. Only there are four records are there with three characters. Lex, Den, Guy, and Pat. Okay, so this is all about pattern matching. So percentile and underscore is representing the pattern matching. And these are very, very important to get the data from the table, guys. Okay. And these pattern matching operators we can use only with the like operator. Only with like operator we can use them. pattern matching operators. Okay, so are you guys clear so far? So this is all about pattern matching operators. So what are the things we discussed? Distinct operator we discussed, and before that we have discussed a few operators. And or not we discussed. And or not, these are the operators we discussed. And also we have discussed about between, not between, not between, we have discussed. And the next one is we have also discussed about pattern matching. Pattern matching is called wildcard characters. We can call it as a wildcard characters. Okay, so by using wildcard characters we can retrieve the data in different formats. And all these operators we can use only with select and where condition. Select and where condition. Okay, so I'll stop this session here, and rest of the topics we will discuss in the next session.